Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, the anti-gun, anti-free speech crowd in the last 3 days since the tragic shooting there in Tucson, Arizona, has been involved in a full frontal assault. Now they're kind of breaking off some of that assault and having to face the facts that this guy was a complete and total fruit loop and registered as a independent and described as a liberal by his friends. Now we're getting a clear image from the neighbors of the father, who was a very angry, reclusive individual, and the mother was very, very nice, and obviously they let their spoiled brat, mentally ill, psychopathic son have his little devil shrine. When he wasn't talking about how great abortion was, he had the devil shrine in the backyard. When the FBI showed up yesterday, the family had the house barricaded ahead of, I guess, neighborhood assaults. They were described by neighbors as the Adams family. And that's why we have the Second Amendment, is to protect ourselves from little spoiled brats turned into psychopathic devils like Jared Lee, who will now go down in history, Mr. Loeffner, as one more of those death-obsessed, lovers of death, bloodthirsty, demonic individuals. If you thought that MySpace, Facebook photos of him were creepy, now the new mugshot of him is even more creepy, and we're going to be showing that while I talk about him throughout the next hour. For radio listeners, you're saying you're going to be showing us that. Obviously, it's been all over the news, all over television, all over the newspapers across the country and the world today. But we're also streaming live at prisonplanet.tv for radio listeners that want to be able to tune in and listen to not just the audio stream, but also visually watch this broadcast. Okay. We got a break here in a few minutes and really officially start the full broadcast. We're going to get into all the latest developments on the Jared Lee Loeffner front. We're also going to get into the fact that it turns out that the suspect had made death threats in the past. The sheriff, when he's not blaming Rush Limbaugh or blaming free speech or the Second Amendment or Sarah Palin and the Tea Party, it turns out that the specific death threats were made. And you know, it's funny. We've gotten death threats here before, and the idiots will leave their name and number. And then we'll go ahead just so there's a record of it in case they come around and we got to defend ourselves. We'll call the police. And it's happened a lot in Austin. And I'll sit there and talk to the detective and I'll say, okay, here's their name and number. I want you to call them. And they'll call them. And the person will just say, oh, I was just joking. And the Austin police don't say, hey, come in and press charges. I know I could force it through and demand it. But they don't really want me to press charges. It's just kind of, oh, well, you can defend yourself if they come around. But I think it is important. I think the next time we can identify somebody who makes a death threat here, that I'm going to go ahead and go to the trouble to go down and file charges on them. I think we've gotten too lax, all of us, with putting up with things like this, whether it's to a congressperson or to a mayor or to a police chief or a judge or a school teacher or an auto mechanic, a medical doctor, it doesn't matter. Somebody threatens to kill you, you need to file a complaint with the police and you need to press charges on that front. I mean, if they clearly say, I'm going to come stick a gun to your head and I'm going to pull the trigger. We had a schizophrenic just a few months ago. Sounded like a redneck schizophrenic. Call up, say, Alex, better quit calling my house. Might have been prank callers, too. They have those soundboard things. People record my voice and do things like that. I'm going to come down there and I'm going to put a gun to his head and I'm going to pull the trigger. And then I call the idiot and say, you know, you better not call here and do that. And I left a message at the number. Then I call the police. These people are nuts. We'll be right back.
Diamond Gusset is proud to announce the anthem of the Patriot Movement. They're offering a free CD, t-shirt, and bumper sticker with a qualifying purchase. Diamond Gusset offers great products at great prices while keeping Americans working.
I'm looking for a factory where a man can feed his family. Not worried about them moving it south, closing the doors and shutting her down tomorrow. I'm looking for America.
Wear American and be proud. Go to gusset.com/America.
The land of the free and the home of the brave. Seems like I just woke up one day and it was gone.
gusset.com/America today.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions, yet many are unaware of the entire function of the Silver Lungs system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs generator. Not only does the Silver Lungs system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lungs system at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lungs system works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Boy, I bet the numerologists, people who are obsessed with numbers, it's akin to the science or pseudoscience of astrology, I bet they're having a field day today. It is 1111. I was signing some paperwork and documents this morning and just noticed that I was adding after my signature 1, 11, 11, or the first month, the 11th day of the 11th year, or it's the 11th year, 11th day of the first month, depending on how you look at it via U.S. style or European calendar style. One angle that hasn't been covered in the Giffords roll green shooting at the hands of the Grim Reaper mass murderer, as I have dubbed him, Jared Lee Loeffner. And that's an angle covered by Paul Joseph Watson. I think it's a very important aspect of this story. Establishment ignores violent rhetoric from eco-leftist. And we did on the Sunday show show the video of the 1010 Project financed by the British government showing children being murdered, 9-year-olds. In a private school setting in England, being asked, will you support carbon taxes? What are you going to do to cut your carbon output of carbon dioxide? And of 20-plus students, the vast majority say, I'm going to submit totally. I'm not going to take a hot bath, you know, things like that. I'm, you know, going to walk more places. And several of the children say, I'm not going to do anything. And the teacher says, fine, that's your choice. And then she hits a red button, and they explode, flinging guts and blood and brain matter all over the teacher and the rest of the students. And then it cuts to a boss at a company asking his employees who's going to make cuts. And the majority, of course, in a peer pressure system say yes, but a minority says no, so he murders them. Then it cuts to a soccer team, the same thing. And it just goes on and on and on from there. And there are all these other TV ads and messages in television programs and all these different editorial articles, really by the thousands that I've seen over the years, promoting that humans are parasites, humans are scum, humans are trash, and that little baby humans are some type of larva of the devilish parasite. Because the social controllers know that if they can demonize babies and demonize children, and kind of glamorize abortion, like the new MTV show is doing, how cool it is, how chic it is to murder your baby in the womb and then write poetry about it. You can't make this stuff up. Then you'll devalue all life. And at the end of every nature show that I've seen for decades, they demonize humans at the end and show how horrible we are. We're being taught to hate ourselves and to be guilty and then to pay taxes and lower our standards of living and give up our liberties and be surveilled in the name of the new eco-religion. And it's all anti-human. And it's all about population reduction. And one of the sacraments of it is abortion hating your fellow man and dreaming about forced population reduction. I mean, it's just pushed everywhere. Like Newsweek last year with the cover, The Case for Killing Granny, admitting the death panels and how great it is, and then having a some set system where there's a set size of the pie, and if you're going to get ahead, somebody's got to lose, instead of a win-win-win type psychological economic outlook that is the real reality and that can bring humanity forward and onward and upward to the stars. They want to turn us against each other. So what does Bill Gates say? Well, if we don't give granny health care, we can hire 10 teachers. But if we don't, we've got to lay them off. They're turning us against each other. You know, I hear mainline leftists who mean well all the time on talk radio and read their articles in the news, and they describe how the pie is only one size and how we've got to take from the rich to give to the poor. Well, the real system is the ultra-rich control the big governments of the world, and they use that as a system to consolidate the wealth into their own hands, vertically integrate it, and then shut down avenues for new wealth formation by the middle class. And it's been that way throughout history. The ultra-elite is always waging war against the middle class. And it was they failed to suppress the middle class in the Renaissance in Europe, starting about 500 years ago. And this whole New World Order and Malthusian economics and mercantilism, and which is its modern name is globalism, that is all an attempt to end the Renaissance and bring in a new dark age of control. And so everything we do here is to educate people about that real scenario, that real paradigm, and to resist it. Now, continuing here, this article, again, is from PrisonPlanet.com. Establishment ignores violent rhetoric from eco-leftists. While the establishment has invoked the supposed threat of vitriolic right-wing rhetoric as a tool with which to bludgeon freedom of speech in response to the Tucson shootings, it has conspired to sweep under the carpet the far more extreme and threatening language and images used by so-called leftists in the context of the climate change debate, rhetoric that has led directly to crimes and murders. While Sarah Palin is castigated for using an image of crosshairs targeting political districts, leftists produce violent and bloody films that depict children being liquidated in an orgy of blood and guts for not towing the line of the political dogma of man-made global warming. You've had all these weird cases of parents shooting their babies, shooting their toddlers, and then shooting themselves.